Chris 6 News at Noon continues.
Hi, everyone. Welcome back. We're live here at La Palmera Mall, and we're continuing to track a couple of little showers right across the coastal bend as we take a live look at our CCRV 6 weather bug. This is over on I-7 and Suntide. Had a little bit of some raindrops on the lens earlier, but still it's pretty dry. But use caution if you're going to be out and about on the roadways. And as we look at our temperatures right now, it's already hot outside as temperatures are holding on to the upper 80s here in Corpus Christi, lower 90s out towards the Naval Air Station as well. And even inland areas are not doing too bad into the upper 80s. But still, no matter how you look at it, it's hot. Heat indices 101 here in Corpus Christi, 106 out at the Naval Air Station, as well as our friends up into the northern sections around Live Oak County at 106 degrees there. All right, as we look at our winds, they're not doing too bad. We'll look for winds to stay out of the east-southeast around 8 to 16 miles an hour across the vicinity. But there's the Doppler radar at this point. A couple of little showers lingering in the central parts of the coastal bend and near the coastline as well. We'll look for additional activity to build off in the Gulf of Mexico and make its way inland later on this afternoon, especially as we get more daytime heating going. So this afternoon, we'll look for an afternoon high of 92 degrees. Scattered thunder showers will remain in the forecast with east-southeasterly winds at 8 to 16, as I mentioned a little while ago, with afternoon highs in the upper 80s to lower 90s along the coast and upper 90s for our inland areas. As we look at the future tracker later on this afternoon, again, we'll look for the opportunity for some of those heavy tropical showers. This is all tropical shower in as far as the amounts are concerned, so they can drop hefty amounts in a very short amount of time, so we're going to be watching that pretty closely. Those go away into the overnight hours, and then early tomorrow morning, we start with some showers along the coastline once again, and we'll repeat the process going on Wednesday afternoon with additional activity. I think this is a little bit underdone at this point, but nonetheless, we will look for that opportunity there. As we look at the satellite radar composite again, we have some very, very hefty amounts of moisture that are coming in off of Mexico, streaming right over the Lone Star State. And in fact, in central Texas, as I mentioned earlier, in San Antonio, a lot of rainfall. They're still dealing with some flash flooding there. But of course, the big story continues to be all that rain. Look at that in the central part, just north of San Antonio, around 6 to 8 inches of rain. And a lot of this fell out in the watershed. So that's technically some good news, but not good news for the folks that are experiencing the flooding at this point. There's Tropical Storm Gordon already starting to get some rainfall bands in the panhandle of Florida at this point. The latest coordinates coming in from the National Hurricane Center have the winds at 65 miles an hour, gusting to 75, with tropical storm warnings and hurricane warnings across northern sections of the Gulf of Mexico. We are far-fetched from Tropical Storm Gordon at this point, so we are not expecting any direct impact, so that's certainly some good news. As we go ahead and look at the forecast track here, right now they have it making landfall just after probably about midnight for tonight and continuing to make its way inland throughout the rest of the afternoon and, of course, over the next several days. So here we'll expect increased rip current risks, increased swells as well, and that's going to be about it. As we look at our NEC Co-op Energy 7-day forecast, we go to 92 this afternoon. Scattered thunder showers for Wednesday and Thursday as well. More isolated in nature Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, but still a very tropical air mass continues to be in place.